I'll tell you what, I'm excited this morning. I'm excited that you're here. We're going to worship together. We're going to worship the King of Kings. Amen? Yeah. Amen, no doubt. Would you stand with us and let's worship. Confidence. His Holy Spirit gives us confidence to carry out things that He is doing in our lives. Amen.
To lose, I'm feeling called upon. and shine and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see them fall. I'ma stand up, stand by when you call. Jesus, Jesus.
Truth, he's calling every one of us. He's placed in you gift. Your gifts aren't the same as mine, and he's calling each and every one of us to use those gifts he's planted in us to reach the world around us. He's going to love through us, and he's going to reach the world, but it's our voice that he's using to reach all those around us. And I don't know about you, but it makes me overcome by his presence of this majesty, this God that created the universe would still choose to use me, little me, to be able to speak to the nations. And he's calling each one of you, all the people around you, to use you to speak to the nations, the people around you. And he's saying, I'm calling you all by name. If that doesn't make you come undone, I don't know what will. Amen.
Victory is yours.
you have to say. Lord, I'm tired of all my guilt, tired of all my pain. Break these chains and set me free. Lord, you know I want to be wild free. Don't you know? I've been living a lie I just couldn't see, holding on to things I just didn't need. Took these hands and you washed them clean. Oh, I've been lost in the middle of the night. You came down and you opened my eyes. I won't. Oh, my Jesus did for me.
That's so cool. I find it amazing that God says, I am so perfect, I can't have sin in my presence. If I am, it will be crushed, it will be destroyed. And he knew that we needed to be washed clean. So what did he do? Boom, you're washed clean. Now we can enter into his presence. Oh, I don't know about you. You have the opportunity to come to the table every time we're together, every time you come before the Lord. Sometimes we shy away because we look at our past, but don't do that. Jesus says, listen, I'm calling you, come to the table. He has something for you today. And as we next song, let this be our prayer that we would come to the table and receive. He's laid something on our pastor's heart. That's pretty awesome that he's given us something. And not only that, but he gave us a pastor to give it to us. Amen. Woo.
Hear the voice of love that's calling. There's a chair that waits for you and a friend who understands everything you're going through. You keep standing at a distance, the shadow of your shame. But there's a light of hope that's shining
Won't you come and take your place? Bring it all to the table. There's nothing he ain't seen before. For all your sin, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it table. He can see the weight you carry, the fear that holds your heart. But through the cross you've been forgiven, you're accepted as you are. So bring it all to the table. There's nothing he ain't seen before. For all your trials, all your worries and your burdens, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. You are so worthy of praise. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You are a lover. You have come down to teach us, to love on us. And Lord, we're ready. We're ready to hear from you. So we just thank you. The scripture says when two or more are gathered in his name, that he'll be with them. We know you're here, Lord Jesus. And not only do we know, we don't just sense your presence. We know you're here, but we're ready to accept. I don't want to leave here the same person that came in. I want to leave more motivated, more intense with your love. Lord, speak through our pastor. Speak to our hearts this morning. Give us wisdom. Give us the love we need and the direction we need. We ask that you send your Holy Spirit on him in such a way that he would speak words that would directly penetrate our hearts. That as he does that, your blessing would fall upon him. Lord, what an example that you've given us, that we would be able to watch him and follow his lead as he receives from you. What a blessing that is, Lord. And Lord, we'll be careful to give you all praise and glory in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
no doubt. Buckle up and hold on. At our church, we love God. Make no mistake about that. At our church, we believe in God's radical, unconditional, and unwavering love for us. At our church, we believe that Jesus is God. We also affirm that you may or may not believe that Jesus is God. And we're not asking you to change your belief system before you attend our church. We're simply inviting you on a journey toward Jesus. For years, churches have placed a high priority on Jesus as the get-out-of-hell-free card. At our church, we place the highest priority on Jesus as a live-life-to-the-fullest invitation. At our church, we believe every person has a dream deep inside their hearts, and that God put that dream there, not for our glory, but for His. At our church, we're not concerned with where you've been, but where you're going. At our church, we believe that the Bible is God's Word. It is real, it is living, it is active. We believe that people who don't go to church anywhere are not the enemy. They are real people who need the perfect love that only God can give. And we believe that God gives this love through, of all people, us. At our church, we do not and we will not display a holier-than-thou attitude toward anyone. We are all broken people, but He is putting us back together. And finally, and most importantly, at our church, we believe that Jesus really lived, that He really died on the cross, and that He really rose again on the third day. And we cannot and we will not candy coat or water down that message, ever. Today, you've chosen to sit yourself in the middle of a very safe place to hear a potentially dangerous message. Welcome to our church.
Good morning. Welcome to Freedom Biker Church, York, PA. My name's Jim Quose. I'm the preacher, and I am
free,
no doubt. Pray with me. Hey, do me a favor. Keep my wife in your prayers. She's doing better. We're so grateful that she wasn't hurt any worse. Rough night last night. She's just trying to rest and relax a little bit. So just keep her in prayer. Thank you. And thank you so much for bringing food, man, and just loving on us, and everybody just checking on her and praying for her. You guys are awesome. You're such a blessing to us, and we appreciate you. Lord Jesus, thank you. Thank you for loving me as I am, Lord, and then thank you for allowing me to share that love with my brothers and sisters, man, with the people, with my people. Lord, with the bikers, Lord, and all the people that just love bikers and all the people that just hang around, all the people that some churches just forget about. Lord, we thank you that you don't forget about us. We thank you that you're with us. You love us. So love us. And we thank you for that, Lord. And I pray today, as I give your message, that it's your words that I speak, and that those words are received. Lord, that ears are open and eyes are open to receive that message that you love us. And Lord, we feel your presence, we invite your presence, we thank you for your presence, and we'll be careful to give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name. And everyone said, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Amen. And hey, guys, if you want a seat, there are seats available. It's really crowded, I know. There's a lot of people here. Praise God for that. But there are empty seats. So if you have an empty seat around you, raise your hand in case anybody wants to sit down. So see, you go, there you go, there are some empty seats. Okay. Announcements. Marshall, where you at, Marshall? Marshall's got an announcement for us. Right.
Marshall.
Marshall.
Hey guys, so yesterday, if you were at the Sons of Thunder breakfast, you got this announcement. Here is the official announcement. Attention, Sons of Thunder. Where are you at?
Woo!
Let's go see some fights. So this is going to be a work in progress. You see the date, Saturday, March 16th. This is Faith and Family Night. As of right now, since the work in progress, I have 20 seats reserved in Section 206 at Center Ice. It's up top. 16 a person. See me. we don't need money for a long time. And in fact, if we get more than 20, I can call back in and reserve more. But you'll see this on the loop and everything. So if you have any questions, come see me, and I'll be taking care of it. We'll probably meet maybe here. We're not sure about driving situation. Again, work in progress. I've just had a lot of you guys asking to go to a hockey game, and I said, okay, I'll do it. So thank you.
Yeah, man. So Marshall got voluntold to set up the hockey game. So, Matt, if you like to watch people fight on the ice, you might be at Freedom Biker Church, York, PA. Yeah, right. Yep, okay, so I don't advocate violence, but I do like it sometimes. Yeah, that's going to hurt somewhere, I'm sure. I don't care. Hey, man, so we have some handicap parking now out here, 6 spots out here. And for anybody that has, you know, that has a hard time walking up to the thing, that could be my wife today if I came, right? So if you have a handicap sticker, great. If you don't and you park there and somebody says something, just tell them why you're parked there, right? And if you have a good reason, we're cool. We're not going to try to take somebody's handicap parking space, right? Right, unless if we don't need it. So I'm not going to call the cops on you or anything. New Year's Eve party right here at Freedom. We're going to do we've been doing it for a couple years now, and I think this is the 3rd year we're doing it, and we basically just open up the church on New Year's Eve for anybody that wants to hang out. We're going to have lots of fun, lots of games. You can shoot pool. We'll probably do some cornhole. If you want to bring lawn darts, I'm not responsible. There's a big field over there. If the cops come, I don't know who you are. Hey, whatever, right? And no alcohol, no drugs, and no attitudes. That's the only requirement. All right? Sons of Thunder yesterday, man, we had a great breakfast out at the Stuffet, and it was awesome. Yeah, the Stuffet, man, that's what we did. We Stuffet'd. And, man, this church is great, man. Every time we do something, you show up, man, but you make an impact, right? And that's what's really important, right, is that people see the love we have for one another, right? Because that's what the Bible said. Jesus said, they will know my followers because they love each other. Right, because the love that they have for one another, and man, when you guys show up somewhere, it doesn't have to be. It ain't forced. It ain't faked. It's all real, and people are impacted. Yeah, man. Okay, I think that's all the announcements I have. At this time, we're going to take our offering. No cover charge here at Freedom Biker Church. But if you like what's going on, and man, I know, God has huge plans for this church and this community, man. He is activating you guys, and you guys show up like no other church I've ever seen in my life. And that is the truth. That's the truth. Yeah, you guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. So if you want to make an investment in the kingdom, this is your opportunity to do so.
Shared what I could. is all. If you give a little love, you can get a little love of your own. Don't break his heart. Sun and moon to you, and if you share
with your heart,
yeah, you give
with your heart.
What you share with the world is what it keeps of you.
Really cool. That video is really cool because it kind of illustrated what I was just talking about, right? And what's cool is like they're just these small little random acts of kindness, and these people are just doing it out of the goodness of their heart, the love in their heart, and people are watching, and they don't even know that anybody's watching, but the people that are watching are then impacted, right? And then I'd like to point out something else too. At the end of the video, right, you see where the young man is painting over the graffiti, and you see the other three guys standing back there. And at first, you know, they're kind of mocking him a little bit, right? Or that's what it appears, that they're kind of like, hey, look at this guy, and, you know, laughing a little bit. But as people join in, man, and more people get together, they actually are impacted so much that they start to step up and help. You know, so just like negativity and some of the things that come against us, the enemy brings against us, can bring us down, so can love overcome those things, right? And, you know, so as we do our thing that we call church here, we're different, right? There's no doubt about it. I'm different, right? I mean, when I walk in a group of pastors, I stand out, right? when people... Not in a good way always, okay? And when, you know, when people say, this is our pastor, they go, really? This is your pastor, okay? So, you know, the point is that sometimes there's people, they're going to stand back and they're going to question, and they're even going to mock it a little bit, right? And it's oftentimes other Christians. Oftentimes it's going to be other churches because they're going to say, that's not the way we do church. And you know what I would say to them? You're right. That you're right. That's why we don't do church that way, right? Jesus intended church to be. Right? We go out, right? Matthew 11, 18, 19 says, for John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, he has a demon. Then the Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, here is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners, but wisdom is proved right by her deeds. Right? So in other words, it didn't matter how, you know, it doesn't matter how you come at people, right? You can come like John and you can be fasting and spiritual and wandering around the desert seeking God, and they say, this guy's got a demon. Right? Or you could be like Jesus that comes and he sits and he drinks and he eats with people and he loves people that other people don't love, that the religious people don't care about. And they say, this guy is a drunkard and he hangs out with sinners. It doesn't matter what you do, someone's going to criticize it, right? But what it says in the end is, wisdom is proved right by her deeds. If you love people, you obey God's command, right? Love the Lord your God with all your heart and love your neighbor as you love yourself. If you and then Jesus says, if you do those two things, everything. If we do that, it doesn't matter what people say about us. It doesn't matter if people criticize us. It doesn't matter to me if they say, you're a preacher. I don't care. Because there's only one that I'm worried about. His name is Jesus Christ, and he told me to love people. Even the people that criticize me. Right? If we do that, we will be proved wise in God's eyes by our deeds. Right? Just like those kids were, in the end, they were convicted to go help paint the graffiti away. Really cool image, I think. Best Christmas ever. So we had a pretty good Christmas this year, but the best Christmas ever, and I want to talk about this because kind of speaks to the people of the best Christmas ever, right? The best Christmas ever was the day Jesus was actually born, right? And what happened that day was the angels call a group of people. Well, the first group of people God calls two very unusual groups of people for that day and time to come witness this event. To come, so Christmas is over, right? We're done. Christmas Day's over. All the packages are ripped open, and you know half the stuff that we got is already in the closet or whatever. But now comes the time. So Jesus was born, but now comes the time that God makes the announcement. And people come to see Jesus, right? So here we are, Christmas is over, we're coming to see Jesus, right? And he calls two groups of people, and they're very unusual groups of people for God to call. First is the shepherds, right? Because the shepherds are like on the social ladder of things, they're among the bottom rung, right? They're all day, right? I mean, all day and all night. And they sleep with them. They smell like them. Right? I mean, so when they walk into church, you go, wow. Okay, guys. You know, soap and water. That's all we ask. But you know, I mean, in that day, they were who they were, right? And they were the people that if the Pharisees were looking to invite them to a big religion, not be at the top of the list, they might not even be on the list, right? It says in God's word, and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, do not be afraid. Because God knew when he called these guys and hang out with sheep by themselves in the fields, in the middle, you know, at nighttime, they were going to be scared. Right? So the first thing the angels say is, do not be afraid. But then what's more important is, they go on to explain why they shouldn't be afraid, right? And this speaks to our lives because often we're afraid, right? When my wife got hit by a car and I got called, I was afraid, right? I have faith in God. I know God is sovereign. I know all that, but I was afraid that something really terrible had happened, right? But then they go on to tell us why, and this is on Luke 2, 8 through 12, by the way. Goes on to tell us why we shouldn't be afraid. It says, this is what the angel said, I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Okay, so the angels appear. If you're laying in bed at night and an angel appears, let's say this angel looks like me, then you'd really be scared, right? And he says, hey, you're afraid, right? And I say, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. You know why? Because I got good news for you, man. I got good news not only for you, for everybody, right? Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you, and he is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. That's how you'll know. Because guess what? There weren't babies lying in mangers all over the place in Bethlehem, right? There was only one. So when the shepherds went into town, they would know right away that that's the one the angel was talking about, right? Then the shepherds, what do the shepherds do to them? Right? You get an angel appears, they tell you this great news and say, go look, and hopefully we're smart enough to go looking, right? And the shepherds, in Luke 2:13, it says, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. Let's go check this out. So they're the first group that are invited, right? So now, in our life, right, when God calls, what do? Do we answer? Right, because these guys are simple men. They weren't guys that, again, were invited to the synagogue all the time. They weren't intellectuals. They weren't theologians, right? They were just guys that watched the sheep, right? But when God calls, they go. They don't question. They leave their flocks. It says they leave their flocks. This is the most important thing in their life right now, is watching these sheep, right? But they say, let's go. Let the sheep wander, man. We'll get them later. Let's go. When God calls, do we go? When God calls, do we step out? Or do we say, well, you know, I got work to do. It's not really convenient right now. I was going to go home and watch TV. There's a football game on today. Is that what we do? Or do we say, you know what? Let's go do what the Lord said that we should do. Right? Lord's call. Mike Beasley's our preacher down in Clayton. He's the one that started all this. So if you ever meet Mike Beasley, say thank you for following God's vision for Freedom Biker Church, right? And Mike Beasley said, if we're doing our job right, we will smell like the sheep, right? We're shepherds. That's what the Bible says. And if you're a really good shepherd, you're going to smell like the sheep because you're going to be with them. and you're going to be part of them. They're going to be part of your family, right? So we should be in the pit, man. We should be there. We should be where our people are, man. Right? We shouldn't be running away from them. There's another group of people that God called, and this is the wise men, or the magi, as they're referred to. Now, if you look at that word magi, what's it look like? It kind of looks like the word magic, right? Looks like the first part of the word magic. And so these guys that were coming from the east, you know, we hear the story. I've heard the story many times and never really thought about it a whole lot, but these magi come from the east. When they come to see Jesus in Bethlehem, when they're heading to Bethlehem, the Pharisees aren't going, "Great, here come these wise men." They're not saying that, right? Because to them, these guys are like sorcerers, right? These guys are guys that they got, they're not even sure what their religion was, but they're not Jews. Right? They're spiritual, right? You hear that all the time now, right? I'm not really a Christian. I don't really go to church, but I'm spiritual, right? So these guys were spiritual. They were intellectual. They were well-read. They read the scriptures, right? And they were stargazers. They looked at the stars. They looked at God's creation. They were somewhat mystical. And the Jews didn't like them. But God loved them. And God knew they were paying attention. God knew that they were reading the word and they were paying the attention. And he was going to lead them to his son. It says in Matthew 2:1-2 and 4-6, it says, "After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, magi from the east came to Jerusalem and said, 'Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him.' When he had called them together, all the people, so then Herod calls together all his people," right? Because now Herod's the king of the Jews, literally at that point in time. And here come these wise men. They say, "Hey, we're looking for the king of the Jews." And Herod's thinking, "Well, you found him. I'm right here," right? But they're saying, "No, we're talking about the one God sends." And Herod didn't like that, right? So he's trying to figure out where he is. He calls all his intellectual, theological people together, right? And he says he called them together, all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, and he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. And they said, "In Bethlehem in Judea, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Okay, so the magi show up. They ask Herod, "Where's the king? You know, we're looking for the king of the Jews." Herod figures out through his people that they're in Bethlehem. He really calls the Magi. So the Magi, all they're doing, they're not Christians, they're not converted, they're seeking. Been there? They're seeking. They're just wondering. They know God. They know there's a God. They're looking to his creation. They find his word. And they say, "I want to seek God." And God says, "Look for this star," right? There's a lot of arguments scientifically, whatever, what this star was. God is supernatural, man. I don't know. It could have been a comet. It could have been a big star. It could have been a light that God just put up in the sky to say, "Here's where my son is." But these guys were paying attention. And God drew them to his son, not only physically, right, but once they got there, they bowed down and worshiped Jesus. Right, because if you travel through life and you seek God and God gives you an instruction, and you follow that instruction, and you find out that it's just the way God said it was going to be, now you found God. Now God has revealed himself to you. So they could have came as magi, sorcerers, or whatever they were, but they left as worshipers of Jesus Christ, God's own Son, because they found God, literally. Is that awesome? That is awesome. That was the best Christmas ever, right? So modern day, what happens in modern day? How's that apply to us? I think it applied to us all Christmas season, man. Here we are, a bunch of people that no one would really expect God to call. I mean, really, right? If you were lining up all the church people and all the, you know, whatever, and you said, it's sort of like when Jesse lined up his sons, right? And David's not even there, right? If they were going, hey, they put me in a room of people and then say, pick out the preacher, pretty much whatever the people look like, I'm probably not going to be the first choice, right? We're probably not going to be the first ones that people would say, God is going to use these people to do great things. It doesn't matter what people think. It only matters who God is. I don't care what people think. I've known bikers my whole life. They're some of the best people, most genuine, real, good-hearted people I've ever met in my life. And God knows that. That's why God put this church here. Because he knew, man, we're going to bring Christmas presents to kids that don't have Christmas presents, man. We're going to give trees to people that don't have trees. We're going to bring food to the food bank. Daily bread, right? We're going to get, man, I don't even know how many people. I showed up at this church on Christmas Eve, right? What a great Christmas, right? Everybody, we're going to have a Christmas party? Yeah, we had a Christmas party, man. We had the best Christmas party ever, right? I showed up late, because that's what I do. I showed up late, and it looked like we were having church, because we were. We were having church here, but, I mean, it literally looked like a Sunday morning. There were cars everywhere. I walked through. I couldn't even get through to the coffee bar. People had tables set up. They were making food. They were putting together boxes. They were gathering all the stuff that had been donated and collect it, and they were in and out with boxes to the vehicles that went downtown. And then we went downtown, and we gave it all away. And people came from everywhere to get it, man. And, you know, when I showed up, Lewis is the guy that was helping us to set up the tables and set up the tent and all that. When we first showed up, Lewis was like, man, you guys got a lot of stuff, a lot of people. He said, they're doing a thing up the Elks, so I don't know if there's going to be that many people here. He said, so we might have to, you know, take this stuff back and do it another day. And I said, well, let's see what happens, you know, let's see how it goes. And there was two guys there from the bus station, and they showed up, and I don't know, they must have been the town criers or something, because it literally, in no time, people were piling down there. And Lewis said, man, I've been doing this for a lot of years, but I've never seen anything like this. He said, I've never seen so many people from the church show up. He said, we always get a lot of people show up that need stuff, right, that are in need. But I've never seen the actual people from the church, this many of them, show up for something. Right? We are different. We are different. In a good way. In a good way. Doesn't matter what you say. You know, and I grew up in this life, man, and I guarantee you that's what's different about us, right? It never mattered what I said. Don't talk the talk. walked walk. That's what you guys are doing, man. And that's why this has been one of the best Christmases ever. Right? Despite everything that's going on and Satan attacks. Man, Satan has been attacking me since the day I walked out of work. Steady. You ever feel like that? Satan attacks, man. But you know, and hey, sometimes I'm afraid. You know, I'm not going to sit here and say, I'm a rock, man. Yeah, I just punch Satan right in the nose. No. You know, I fear. But I have a Savior. I have a friend. Right? Jesus said, not only am I going to call you my disciples, I'm going to call you my friend. I have a friend, man. And that friend is bigger and badder than Satan will ever be. Right? And just when I think he got me down, Jesus picks me up. So even in the midst of some of the bad things that are going on, I can stand up here and say, man, this is one of the best Christmases ever. No doubt. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you've been hanging around here, and you've been downtown, and you've been a part of all of this, what are you waiting for? Right? Do you need to walk? Do you need to sit on the back of a donkey and get knocked off, like Paul did? What are you waiting for, man? I'm not here to save you, but I'm here to introduce you to the one that will. Right? I'm not here to make your life better, but I'm here to introduce you to the one who will fulfill the purpose of your life, who created you, who gave you gifts in order to fulfill a specific purpose that he has for you. And all you have to do is receive that gift. Don't just receive it though, man. When you get that gift, open it up. Open it up and let it be a part of you. Right? And then go out and share it with everybody you can. That's my prayer for you today. Pray with me. Oh, Lord Jesus, man, we thank you so much for your presence. So much for your blood. So much because of what you did on that cross, we are reconciled with God. That we can be not only your followers, not only your disciples, but your friends. Lord, thank you for your love. Thank you for allowing us to feel that love and share that love with our community. And Lord, I just pray that you'll give us the strength to ignore the noise, man, to ignore the enemy. Fear is a liar. Lord, help us to overcome. Speak to my heart, speak to our hearts and say, do not be afraid. Because on this day, a Savior has been born. And that Savior lived, died, and was resurrected because God so loved the world. Lord, I just pray as we go forward, that you would just lead, guide, and direct us, Lord. Protect us. Protect us from the evil one, Lord. And when he knocks us down, pick us back up. And Lord, we'll be careful in everything that we say and everything that we do to give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Amen.
Amen. Good message. Good message. I don't know about you, but my heart was moved. And I will follow the one that's my hero till the day I die. Jesus My Hero. Takes your sins away and gets you out. Truth is found within reading His word. Music, evidence, praise Him out loud. Jesus, my hero, He's conquered darkness. Prophecy was carried out. Truth is found within reading His word. Use that evidence, praise Him out loud. Jesus, my hero, He's conquered all. Given you and touch the world around you. Be start smelling like some sheep. Amen. Amen. No doubt. See you next week.